I'm Elizabeth Mikautadze, the artistic director of Mikautadze Dance Theater. And we, together with my husband, David, we founded Mikautadze Dance Theater in 2008. And we got our residency at PFW's College of Visual and Performing Arts in 2012. And we've been holding annual concerts at Williams Theater every spring, except for this year is a little bit different due to COVID. That's why we're presenting our video show this year.
I'm David Mikautadze, music director of Mikautadze Dance Theater. I'm a composer as well and a jazz guitar player. I also work at Sweetwater Sound, where I'm a sales engineer. I composed 377 as one of the first pieces MDT has choreographed. Actually started out as a audition piece for our first set of dancers back in 2008, right?
Yeah.
Wow, long time ago. And it was initially just going to be this audition piece, and that was going to be it. But we liked what Elizabeth choreographed to it, and we wanted to make it longer. So I took the part that I composed, and I made that the end. And then I composed part one and two for it, and we kind of glued it all together. It's based on the numbers in the Fibonacci series. I love numbers, and I felt I could integrate it somehow into the composition. So the piece is called 377, is 377 seconds, which is the 14th number of the Fibonacci series. And there's the big important sections in the work all land on bar numbers that are in the Fibonacci sequence. And the tempo of the piece is 144 beats per minute, which is also a Fibonacci number.
It's definitely our most versatile work, and the movement is very angular and based in tempo and like based on time. There's some references physically to like the ticking of a clock or passage of time.
Thank you.
say that any of the choreography was necessarily connected to the pandemic. I basically went with the dancers that I had for the season and used the rep that either they already knew or rep that I knew would work on them. I did have a few lineup changes with dancers right in the middle of the season. I had one leave and one come in, so they kind of just exchanged roles in one of the pieces. And the piece Passage came up because I knew I wanted to add another duet to that, and I wanted it to be a male duet, and I had the two male dancers. So that is the one of the new pieces of choreography in this show. I think by the time we got into the studio with the mask, everybody was already so used to wearing them. There was a little bit of, I remember when we first started jumping and doing more athletic movement in the studio, where the dancers were like, whoa, you know, like this is way harder than it used to be. And we took a lot of breaks out in the hallway, like to just drop the mask and get a breath. But I think the more we, you know, we're doing big leaps and big running patterns of movement with those masks on, they actually developed like stronger lungs. And by the time we got to the show and removed the mask, that they were all saying that it's almost like they got stronger. Thank you.
I guess I'll start since since it kind of started with me. But basically, I work on video games and game music. I got together with a writer from Montreal and a couple artists. There was a Chilean and an Argentinian artist that was working on the art for the game. So it was just a really interesting combination of people. And I made the music in about 48 hours. I decided that I wanted to consider pushing forward with it somehow. And then I immediately thought of the Mikitadze Dance Theater just because I knew that they would be able to approach this music in an interesting way, and that I could trust them to do something cool with it. So I thought, oh, let's do some sort of dance film. So I went to Elizabeth and asked you.
I'm glad you did. It's been definitely a different project for us. We've never worked with dance knowing that ultimately it's going to be for film and not necessarily for a concert dance. So we definitely were able to be a little bit more experimental with some of the ideas of how to approach the choreography and thinking about, like, you know, hey, maybe this choreography is a little strange, like on stage, but once we start talking about different angles, or we talked about the idea of like different cuts or maybe like some props, that some things that appear maybe flat in concert dance will be very dimensional on a dance film. And I think that something that kind of came out like of your music is that when you first listen to the music, it's kind of like moments are really light and kind of like whimsical a little bit. But then when you put the choreography with it and the concept behind it that we talked about, it actually becomes a little eerie. There's an eerie quality to some of the movement. And I feel like when you think about time passing, like when you think about your own past or you think about people that you know that have passed, there is like a strange, like kind of like anxiety that I think a lot of us have when we talk about like that passage of time.
Yeah, so you'll see some clips of that stage performance of the choreography. But the thing that we're planning on doing, and I've been making shot lists, and we're thinking about set pieces and just thinking about it as a film, with you know all the choreography is basically like the acting of the film. And so, yeah, just figuring out where to put the camera. I can put it anywhere. I don't have to just put it right in front of the stage. And the camera's constantly moving, doing a lot of dolly shots, and just trying to really get into the film process. So that we're about at the end of, we basically shot the whole dance, how I planned to shoot it with the camera angles and all that. And now we're just thinking about those last aspects of makeup and set design and all that. And then once we get all that finished, we'll do the real thing in this room, actually.
Thank you. interesting, you know, going into it and knowing that I would have the opportunity to like, oh, hey, let's stop and redo that section because let's make that the best we can. I thought we would be doing that all day long, like stop, start, stop, start. But I feel like a lot of it actually did kind of go smoothly the same way a show would, where, you know, we did the piece and the dancers performed as if there was an audience and we were able to just kind of do one take. I mean, some pieces I think we went back and tried different, you know, a different approach, or we didn't have like really, like if it would have been a live show, I don't think we would have had too many blunders. So.
Yeah, I think also it's hard to capture the energy without an audience. And when I was watching, you know, the videoing, the dancers had good energy. It was like as if there was an audience, you know, and that's really
hard. I think they were thinking about it.
They were excited about it, just finally dancing, like on a stage and like, you know, being dancers.
Wish I knew why I'm so in love with you. No one else in this world will do. Darling, please save your love for me. Run away. If I were wise, I'd run away. But like a fool in love, I stay and pray you'll save your love for me. I can feel it even when you're not here. Can't conceal it, I really love you, my dear. And though I know no good can come from loving you, I can't do a thing. Oh, I'm so in love with you. So darling, help me please. Have mercy on a fool like me. I know I'm lost, but still I plead. Darling, please save your love for me. You may have fun with a crowd, but for crying out loud, darling, please save your love for me.
So Sinner Man was choreographed basically in line with the lyrics of the music, and, you know, exploring that idea of there being the sinner and having to choose between good and evil, being tempted by the devil and being warned by God of what the right thing is to do. And it's, you know, it combines stylistically modern movement with a little bit of what I would say contemporary jazz movement. The original version of Sinner Man had a tap dance solo for the character that plays the devil, and we adapted that a little bit for Zach Fensler, who's the dancer in Sinner Man in this presentation.
Oh, Sinner Man, where you gonna run to? Sinner Man, where you gonna run to? Where you gonna run to? All on that day,
till I run to the rock. Please hide me, I run to the rock. Please hide me, I run to the rock. Please hide me, Lord, all on that day. But the rock cried out, I can't hide you, the rock cried out. I can't hide you, the rock cried out. I ain't gonna hide you, Dad, all on that day. I said, Rock, what's the matter with you, Rock? Don't you see I need you, Rock? Lord, 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 all on that day. So I ran to the river. It was bleeding around to the sea. It was bleeding around to the sea. It was bleeding all on that day. So I ran to the river. It was boiling around to the sea. It was boiling around to the sea. It was boiling all on that day. So I ran to the Lord. Please help me, Lord. Don't you see me praying? Don't you see me down here praying? But the Lord said, go to the devil. The Lord said, go to the devil. He said, go to the devil. All on that day. So I ran to the devil. He was waiting around to the devil. He was waiting around to the devil. He was waiting all on that day. I cried, power, 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 power.
Cinnamon, where you gonna run to? Cinnamon, where you gonna run to? Where you gonna run to? All on that day, will I run to the rock? Please hide me and run to the rock. Please hide me and run to the rock. Please hide me, Lord.